Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 has hundreds of changes and features. And while if you count everything, there's about 400 changes or so to all of the different system settings and little icons and things throughout, there are some major changes that I think are super helpful. And while there's not a ton of visual changes like many people wanted, there are a lot. So I thought I'd go over the top iOS 15 features, not only according to me, but according to you. And so a couple months ago, I asked on Twitter, do you have a favorite feature of iOS 15? And if so, what is it? And based off of this, with about 70,000 views or so and hundreds of comments, I took the top information and thought we'd go over some of those. So some of them range from minor changes to major changes, but I took all of the major changes. And the first one is unfortunately not coming to iOS 15 upon its initial launch. And that has to do with SharePlay. And SharePlay is something that's featured by Apple on their iOS 15 preview page and has been for months. And that's the ability to share movies and music and things together while on a FaceTime call. So that option will not be available at launch, but it's one of the number one wanted features. In fact, my daughter really likes that feature and was kind of bummed to hear that it wasn't coming out initially. So it will allow you to watch together, listen together, share your screen, have spatial audio during that, and much more. So it's really a nice feature that only is going to be delayed according to Apple. But the top feature that a lot of you really liked was weather. The weather app, you'll see I have the widget here. The weather app has been completely redesigned. And so with the weather app, there's a bunch of new features based off of dark sky that Apple actually purchased. Based on the current weather, as you can see it here where I live, if we move over to maybe, let's go to a different area where the weather could be different, maybe Dubai, where it's night, you'll see the background changed. And there's about 1,000 different animations based on this. If it's raining where you live, the animation will rain onto the screen. And as you scroll down, you can see all sorts of information from the overall temperature based off the location here and what the actual quality is of the air. So if we go into the different layers, we have precipitation and air quality and much more. So it gives you all of that. Now, air quality is not available in every country, but it is available in some areas. It also tells you sunrise, UV index, the wind direction, visibility, pressure, and more. So this is great information. You'll see there's a ton of different information here depending on where you live. You'll see it's just changing. So there's different warnings included as well. I think it's a really great app. And for me, there's no reason to use another app because I really, really like this particular weather app. So I think it does a great job and you can see it animates right back into the widget and keeps up mostly in real time. Now, the next thing is focus. A lot of people really like focus modes. Now, I did a separate video completely demonstrating focus and all of the different settings. So I'll just show you briefly, but you can see I have a bunch of different focus modes. These can be accessed in your control center or in settings with different focus, and you can set them up custom as I have with home evening. Based off the focus mode you're on, it changes even your home screen. So you can change your home screen layout. You'll see I have three pages here. If I switch to maybe home evening, it changes everything from notifications to home screens. You'll see my home screen disappeared, and now I just have the one screen with my app library. If I change that back to something else, maybe work, now I'll get notifications from other things. You can even hide notification badges, and you'll see I have a bunch of screens now. So you have that option, and you can have it customized based on your location, where you're at, whether you're working, whether it's the weekend, time of day, and much more. So it's a really helpful app. Some people won't find value in it if you don't use Do Not Disturb and those things, but it's very helpful if you want to focus while you're at work. While you're at home, you can get different notifications and more. So I think that's something that a lot of people will appreciate it and is a little bit underrated if you haven't used it yet. The other thing I hear a lot that people like a lot is live text. Live text lets us take a photo and copy the photo's image text right out of it so we can paste it somewhere else. So you can see this is an iPhone 4 box. And if we switch to the camera and we'll see if it recognizes the text here, you'll see it's sort of putting bars around it. It recognizes text and we can copy that text right here. You'll see if we tap the button that I did in the bottom right, we can copy the text, we can select it, we can translate it, and we can share it. So if I copy it, I can paste it somewhere else. Let's look it up and it will search for it. It searches, it recognizes that it's iPhone 4, searches that term, and then gives us more information. Bookstore, you can search the web and even manage the dictionaries for it. So it's a feature that works really well and it allows you to select that text. Also, the other thing that pertains to photos that a lot of people like is visual lookup. So if we go into photos, within photos, you'll see here's a photo of a flower that I took. And if we tap on it, you have an eye at the bottom and that eye has a little star in the upper left. If we tap on that, it gives us more information about it and it recognizes that it's a plant. If I tap on the image here, it will find similar plants and try and find things that are related. It says it's a rose bush and it sort of finds other images similar to it. Now, I'm not sure that it's a rose. In fact, I don't think that it is, but I could be wrong, but you'll see that it gives more information about it. And it's using visual lookup to not only identify plants, but it can identify animals and landmarks and more. So this is a great feature. And I think one of the best features in iOS, if you use this sort of thing all of the time. Now, the next feature, I think a lot of people have been requesting additional options and more for, and that's notifications. Apple has redone notifications a little bit here. And as you can see, I have a few different ones. Whether they're time sensitive, it will let you know that. You also have notification summaries throughout the day. So you'll have different information that will say while you were away, while you were in focus, and it's better sorted based on time of day. So if I swipe to the left here, we have some options. And we have turn off time sensitive, configure in home, so we can adjust this to give us notifications based on location, and we can view settings or turn it off altogether. We have a bunch of different settings now for our notifications, so we can immediately deliver it, have a scheduled summary, just let us know about it later on, and also the typical notification settings we had before, such as the banner style, or we can have it announce notifications if we're wearing AirPods and more. So there's a lot of settings for customization now within notifications that we didn't have before. It also has a slight visual overhaul as well. So we have those stacked notifications, and as you can see, there's a bunch of them here. Again, for different options, depending on how we swipe, you'll see our options here to clear them all, or we can just press and hold to clear all of the notifications. So I think that's really nice that they've given those options and it can be highly customized based on what you like. So that's a great update to iOS 15. The next thing I thought was a little bit surprising because it's more controversial, and that has to do with Safari. Some people absolutely love this update. I think it is a really nice update. And as you can see here, it is a little bit different and it has the address bar at the bottom. Now this can be customized now, thankfully. So if we tap on the A's, we can change it to the address bar at the top, like it has with iOS 14. If you don't like that style altogether, and you basically have the same browser as iOS 14, but with additional security updates and the ability to add extensions and more. You can also tap on this and then search with your voice right away. So that's something they've added that I think is very helpful. So if we search for iPhone, you'll see it searches for iPhone right away in whatever search engine or whatever you're using, whether that be Google or DuckDuckGo or more. Again, we can move that back to the bottom. We can swipe to go back, and we also have tab groups and much more. So there's a lot of options here, and we have a customizable home page as well. So if I close these, you'll see that we have a customizable home screen, just like we do on Mac and iPad now. So it gives us our privacy report or whatever we customize, and then you have a wallpaper in the background as well. So there's a lot of updates to Safari, additional privacy is more and more, along with private relay if you have iCloud Plus. So I think this is a great update to iOS 15. I think a lot of people will appreciate this. Now, I have a couple more I wanted to share with you as well, and the first one is accessibility. Accessibility features are huge for a lot of people, and I think one of the best accessibility features that's really underrated is the ability to customize your screen and text size based on a per app basis. So if we go into music, we'll go into music, we'll go into my library, and if we go into the control center and we have the option for the text option here, you can just add it in your settings, press and hold. Now we have the option to customize the text size on a per app basis. So we can have it affect all apps or just music only. Maybe we want to make the text much larger in music. We go back out. Now we have huge text. If we go back out and go into maybe we'll go into Safari again, you'll see that the text has not changed. If we go to Apple, it has not been adjusted. But if we swipe back and go to the music app, it's adjusted for that. So we have the option to change it here. We can bring it down and affect that based on a per app basis. So I think it's a super helpful feature that's highly underrated because it's something that I think a lot of people will benefit from. Some apps are more difficult to see than others for some people. So in settings, where we're in our notification settings, if you need settings to be a little bit bigger, you can do that just for settings only. So it's really great to see that. However it works for you is available here. And this customization I think is very valuable to a lot of people, including myself, as I like to change the overall size on a bunch of different apps. So that's one of the best accessibility features. And then another feature that I think, I'm not sure this is an accessibility feature, but it is under accessibility. And that is under sounds. So if we go down to sounds, of course we had sound recognition before, but if we go under audio and visual, we now have background sounds. And background sounds are great for studying. In fact, this is one of the most, I think, simple updates that's super helpful. So if we go into background sounds, we can turn this on and we have the option for different sounds. So we have rain, we have ocean, stream, dark noise, bright noise, and balanced noise. All of these are options that are in iOS 15. So you can tell it to stop when you lock the phone. You can play a sample of it and you can adjust the volume however you'd like. So you have the option to turn that on and you'll see it just says plays background sounds to mask unwanted environmental noise. So they can help you just kind of focus and relax. And I think all of the focus to things like focus and background sounds are a huge addition to iOS 15. And there's a lot of features in addition to what I already mentioned, but I think those are the top that most people are really interested in. There's additions to FaceTime and Wallet and much, much more, Siri and more. And I'll share that in a full review when iOS 15 is fully launched to the public. Let me know what your favorite feature though is in the comments below. And of course I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.